Hi everyone, it's Vicky here, and today I'm featuring Create a Smile Stamps. They have come up with a great release, and I will be using the In Bloom stamp set that's full of beautiful flowers to create a beautiful composition. So I'm going to do some masking today, and I'm going to work with my Misty just because I want to stamp again and again on top of a piece of white cardstock. Now, first of all, I'm going to pick up the biggest of the flowers included in the stamp set. I'm going to place it at the bottom of my paper there, and then I will go ahead and stamp it. By the way, I'm going to stamp everything with Memento Tuxedo Black Ink, just because I plan to color everything with my alcohol markers. Now I'm going to close the door of my Misty. I'm going to stamp the flower, and then just because I want to create a flower composition, I'm going to go ahead and do some masking. So I'm going to use this masking paper, and I'm going to stamp on top of that the flower again. So now I'm going to go ahead and use my scissors and cut the flower out. So this way I will have a mask. I'm going to peel off the backing of my mask, and then I'm going to place it on top of my stamped flower. Also, when you cut out your mask, make sure that you stay just inside the black line, and this is going to help you make masking even easier, and you will not end up having gaps. Now, just because the mask is slightly raised, you will see that when I go ahead and stamp my next flower, I will end up not stamping perfectly. But this is not a problem when you are using the Misty, because you can always add more ink and apply even more pressure just where you need to. And that's exactly what I'm going to do there, since I want to have a perfect impression. And now I will go ahead and do the exact same technique. So I am stamping on my masking paper, since I want to create another mask, and I will go ahead and do this again and again until I'm happy with the composition on my cardstock. So I will pretty much go ahead and stamp all the flowers available in the stamp set, as well as most of the leaves. So you see here, I'm going to stamp many of the images at once. I'm going to apply a good pressure so I know that I don't end up having gaps in between the images. I'm going to check that out, and everything looks perfect. I went ahead and added a few more images around my flower composition. And here is the finished result, and the fun part where you remove all the masking and you see how the flower composition looks like. Now your panel is ready, you can just color it with your favorite medium and place it on top of a card base. But I'm going to show you how we can take it a step further and how we can add dimension on your card. So I want to cut out this bottom part of this cardstock, and I want to leave a white border. You can use your scissors and go ahead straight away and cut it out. If you are not feeling confident with your cutting skills, then you can just use a pencil, just I am showing you here. Draw the lines exactly where you want to cut out. I'm going to zoom in, so hopefully you can see the pencil line there, and then use your scissors and cut it out. I'm not going to do it all over, since I'm good with scissors, and especially now, since I need to go into small areas, I decided to use my ultra fine detail scissors, which are really helpful, and they are going to make this job easier and quicker. Now, as always, you will find links down below in the description area to everything I'm using, including the scissors, as well as the stamp sets. Of course, this is not a quick and easy card. It's not something you can easily recreate or mass produce, but it's definitely a special card, and it's going to look gorgeous at the end. So now that I have cut out my composition, I will go ahead and use my alcohol markers to color everything. As you can see here, I'm using my Alte Nu alcohol markers, and don't be afraid to mix and match different brands of alcohol markers. You can use your Copics with your Alte Nu markers. I will bring in my Spectrum Noirs in a bit. In any case, if you have alcohol markers from different brands, but their colors are close to each other, then don't be afraid, go ahead and mix them up. They will blend beautifully. Now, I'm not going to show you all the coloring of all the flowers, but I am going to let you see how I colored this petal. Now, I always like to do some quick coloring and not spend too much time with my alcohol markers. So that's why I decided to go super quickly today. And instead of using three different shades of the same color, I am only using two. So from the three markers that I have on my table at the moment, I grabbed the middle one to color the whole petal, and I'm not going to touch the lighter one at all. And then with the darker one, I'm just adding shadow at the center of the petal. And you see that it works beautifully. You don't really need to have too many colors to do the shading. So here is the finished piece, and I am planning to stick that at the bottom of my card base, but a little bit raised. So before I go ahead and do that, I am going to add a touch of color on my background, which is going to help my flower compositions to stand even more. And just because I want my background to be very subtle, instead of using my blending tools, I decided to go with this brush. This is a Nuvo brush, and I'm using Broken China, and that's actually Distress Oxide ink. And I'm checking out how much further I need to add my color, and I wanted to start from blue and end up into white. And I really like the look that that brush gives. It's really subtle. And I think that it really helps my flower composition to stand out against that white background. So this is a dual tip brush, as you can see. It is by Nuvo. It's a Tonic Studios product. In the package you get two of them, and you don't really need a lot of these brushes. I will be using the blue tip for any ink pad that I have that has any shade of blue. Now this is a stamp set again by Create a Smile, which is called Card Full of Treasures, and as you can see it's just adorable. I decided to go with a sentiment that says just for you, but as you can see the stamp set is super cute, and it's perfect for birthdays as well as for making cards for moving. Now I'm going to stamp my sentiment there. I used black ink, and that's actually VersaFine, which leaves a nice and crisp sentiment. And all that's left to do now is to add some foam tip at the back of my panel, and then I'm going to stick it at the very bottom of my card base. By the way, the card base is a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5. And of course you can stop here, or if you are like me and I just couldn't help it, I had to add some shine with my shimmer pen by Nuvo. So that was the card for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Here are some close-up photos of the card that I made today. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so already, because this is the way to tell me that you like my videos and you want to see more. Thank you all for watching.